In October 2025, the Royal Navy conducted a milestone trial that could reshape undersea operations. A quantum optical atomic clock, the Tiqker system developed by Infleqtion, was installed aboard the extra-large uncrewed underwater vehicle XV Excalibur, marking the first time such a device has been deployed at sea on a submarine platform. This breakthrough is far from a novelty gadget. Submarines navigating in remote or contested waters face a persistent challenge. Once submerged, they often lose reliable access to satellite navigation, like GNSS or GPS, and must rely on inertial systems whose errors slowly accumulate over time. In that context, a high-precision clock onboard becomes more than a timing reference. It becomes the heartbeat of all positional, timing, and sensor systems. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Royal Navy's test of quantum optical atomic clock is a big step for submarines. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Historically, submarines have used microwave-based atomic clocks or rubidium/cesium standards to keep time and support inertial navigation systems. These work reliably, but over extended missions, they slowly drift. Minor errors in timing translate to significant position errors when navigating underwater for days without surfacing. The Tiqker quantum optical atomic clock changes the equation. Instead of oscillating at microwave frequencies, an optical atomic clock uses much higher frequency transitions in atoms. This is way beyond what the earlier standards achieved. The result? Far better stability, far lower drift, and the ability to keep accurate time in GPS-denied environments. In the trial aboard Excalibur, Tiqker was shown to operate reliably through multiple dive cycles in a real-world naval environment, a ruggedized form not just confined to the lab. Navigation underwater is fundamentally different from surface navigation. On the surface, ships can raise masts, use radars, receive GNSS signals, and visually fix their position. A submerged submarine must rely on dead reckoning. Inertial sensors track acceleration and rotation. Sonar senses the environment, and occasionally it may surface or use periscope GPS to reset its position. Over time, even the best INS drifts. Without periodic position updates, a submarine may lose track of its actual location, unacceptable for precision missions. Here, the quantum clock plays a pivotal role by serving as a stable time reference for inertial navigation systems, sonar arrays, communications, fire control systems, and more. A more accurate clock means less drift in derived navigation solutions, better synchronization of sensor arrays, and improved stealth because the platform can stay submerged longer without needing to surface or get external fixes. In essence, the submarine becomes more independent, more covert, and more resilient. Moreover, stealth is enhanced when a submarine does not need to come near the surface or deploy expendable floats for GNSS locks. The less it signals externally, the less likely it is to be detected. Thus, a compact quantum timing system supports longer submerged endurance and low signature operations. The Excalibur trial highlights an important architectural shift. Rather than being a large specialized piece of lab equipment, Tiqker is designed to be compact and ruggedized for submarine environments, able to withstand pressure, motion, vibration, and thermal cycles associated with diving operations. The installation involved placing the optical atomic clock on the Excalibur platform and integrating it into the vehicle's time and navigation network. Once on board, the quantum clock became the reference for the vessel's positioning, navigation and timing, PNT systems. With this reference in place, all dependent systems, sonar navigation, fire control, secure communications, benefit from better synchronization. As one industry observer put it, A time heartbeat smooths out the noise that causes navigation drift. Beyond mere hardware, software, data links, sensor fusion, and platform integration play major roles. The submarine's autonomy suite must feed inputs from the INS, motion sensors, possibly gravimetric sensors, and the quantum clock, creating an integrated solution that tracks the submarine's position accurately, even when external cues are denied or degraded. This trial demonstrates not only the sensor itself, but the broader system of systems approach the Royal Navy is pursuing. The exercise is still a proof of concept. The Royal Navy has acknowledged the need for further benchmarking against high-grade time standards and full mission-level testing. Integration into operational submarines will require solving issues of reliability, maintainability, size, weight, power constraints, and ensuring the system performs under shock, vibration, temperature extremes, and electromagnetic conditions demanded by submarine operations. The implications of this deployment are multifold. First, for endurance. A quantum-enabled submarine can stay submerged without surfacing or sending communication pings for much longer. That extends patrol duration, increases stealth, and improves mission flexibility. Second, for precision operations. Whether laying mines, deploying undersea sensors, launching unmanned vehicles, or executing covert special forces insertions, knowing your position to within tight margins is essential. Degraded navigation leads to mission failure. With a quantum clock aboard, the margin of error shrinks, allowing more precise undersea operations. Third, for resilience to adversary action, many potential adversaries possess capabilities to jam GNSS, intercept or spoof signals, or force submarines to surface. A navigation system less dependent on external signals is inherently more resilient. The quantum clock gives a platform a measure of independence. Fourth, for autonomy and unmanned systems, Excalibur itself is an extra-large uncrewed underwater vehicle, XLUUV. As naval operations place greater emphasis on unmanned platforms, these will need accurate, reliable navigation without human intervention or external guiding. Installing quantum timing on an unmanned submarine signals the start of a new era, where unmanned platforms can roam with high precision, long endurance, and minimal external support. The Excalibur quantum clock trial is more than a technological curiosity. It is the vanguard of a new undersea warfare paradigm. With the Tiqker optical atomic clock on board, the submarine becomes less dependent on external navigation signals, navigates more precisely, stays submerged longer, and operates more covertly. In an era where the seas are increasingly contested and adversary capabilities include GNSS jamming, acoustic sensors, advanced missiles, and unmanned platforms, these technological advantages amount to operational advantage. As the Royal Navy moves from trial to deployment, we may soon view submarines not just as quiet patrol vessels, but as highly precise, autonomous stealth platforms able to navigate and strike with accuracy in the harshest environments. The quantum clock doesn't change the mission. It changes how the mission is executed. And in modern undersea warfare, how you do it often matters as much as what you do. Additionally, the performance of the quantum clock will ripple into other military applications, secure communications, time-synchronized encryption, target tracking, time-link sensors, networked unmanned systems, and resilient navigation in GPS-denied or contested environments. Looking ahead, the Royal Navy and industry have indicated a broader commitment to quantum and disruptive technologies. The UK has also announced a quantum clock built by the Defense Science and Technology Laboratory, DSTL, promising less than 1 second of drift over billions of years, demonstrating the long-term ambition of the technology